All right, friends. So I am Dhiraj from CENTUM Academy. So we are live again, and we are taking up a question on nuclei chapter. All right. So this is a different kind of question, which is based on some, you know, scenario as such. Fine. So let us see what this question is about. So as you can see on your screen, there is a huge question. All right. So what we'll do, we'll solve it in a step-by-step manner. So there are multiple parts to this question. Fine. So we'll take one by one all of these. So there is a town which has a population of 1 million. So there is a town. Fine. Which has a population of 10 raised to the power 6 people. All right. The average electric power needed per person is 300 watt. So every person requirement is 300 watt. Fine. So the requirement of town is what? So, you know, it must be about the town, which is asked later on. So we are just, you know, readily finding out some of the obvious parameters, like per person energy consumption is given. So I'll find out the consumption by the entire town. So that will be what? 300 into 10 raised to the power 6. So town will require 3 into 10 raised to the power 8 watt. Okay. The reactor is designed to supply power to this town. The efficiency with which thermal power is converted into electrical power is 25%. Fine. So thermal power, if it is 100, then 25 will be converted into electrical power. Fine. So if the requirement of town is this much electrical energy, so how much thermal energy is required to create this much electrical energy? Assume that to be X. Fine. So 25% of X, which is X into 0.25, should be equal to 3 into 10 raised to the power 8 watts. Fine. So X will be equal to what? 3 divided by 0.25, which is 12 into 10 raised to the power 8 joules per second. Fine. So this much amount of heat energy must be supplied to create that much amount of power in the town. Okay. So these are some of the initial analysis we did. Now let us see what is asked. This I'll write here. This is the thermal energy required. Okay. Now part A of the question. Assuming 200 MeV of thermal energy to come from each fission event, find the number of events that should take place every day. Now we know that one fission will give 200 MeV. Okay. If you convert it into joules, you'll get here as 200 into 10 raised to the power 6 into charge of electron. This much joules you'll get, right? So one fission gives this much joule, and the requirement is 12 into 10 raised to the power 8 joules every second. Fine. So every second, how many reactions should take place? Let's call that as N, and that will be equal to 1.2 into 10 raised to the power 9, which is X. Okay. That divided by this energy. Okay. That is equal to 2 into 1.6 into 10 raised to the power. This is 8, and that is minus 11. Okay. So this many events should happen per second. Okay. Now, how many events should happen per day? That will be equal to N into 24 hours, 60 minutes, into 60 seconds, right? So this is the answer for part A. This many events per second. So per day, if I have to find out, I have to multiply that with number of seconds one day has. Okay. So like this, you can do part A of the question. All right. Let us see what is part B. In part B, assuming that the fission to take place largely through uranium-235, at what rate will the amount of uranium-235 decrease? Okay. We know that every second, this many fission reactions should happen. Fine. And one fission will consume one nucleus of uranium-235. Fine. So how many nucleuses will get consumed of uranium-235? It will be equal to this only. Number of events per second will be equal to number of nucleus that should get consumed every second. Isn't it? Now, if you want to find out what is the mass rate of consumption, all you have to do is divide this n with the Avogadro number. Fine. If you divide it with Avogadro number, you'll get number of moles that should get consumed every second. This divided by 6.023 into 10 raised to the power 23. Fine. So this is number of moles of uranium-235 that should get consumed every second. Fine. Now, what is the consumption rate in terms of mass? You can multiply this with the molecular mass or the molar mass, sorry. So if you multiply this with 235, you will get grams per second that should get consumed. Gram per second that should get consumed. Okay. So if you want to find in terms of kg per second, you just divide it with 1000. Fine. So like this, you can do the B part of the question. Okay. Now it says that you should also express in kg per day. So this is gram per second. So I'm sure you will be able to convert gram per second in kg per day. All right. So we can move to the C part of the question. Assuming that uranium enriched to 3% of 235 uranium that will be used, you need to find how much uranium is needed per month. All right. So in B part, we have got how many kgs of uranium-235 is required per day. Fine. Let's call that as Y. So this much uranium-235 suppose is required per day. Fine. So for 30 days, what is the requirement of uranium-235? That is 30 into Y. Okay. This much uranium-235 is required per month, kg per month. All right. Now, this much uranium-235 is required, but uranium doesn't exist in pure 235. It is written that only 3% of naturally occurring uranium has uranium-235. Okay. So if that is the case, we can say that if X kg of uranium, naturally occurring uranium, is required, then this into 3%, which is 0.03, will be equal to 30 into Y. Okay. So if you solve this equation, you'll get the value of X. And X is the X is the amount of naturally occurring uranium that you require to conduct all this. Okay. So I hope you have learned something today. In case you have any doubts, feel free to get in touch with us and we'll be, clearing your doubts. Hello friends, this is Dhiraj. So today also I have taken up a question, and this question is from radioactivity chapter. All right. So let's see what this question is about. So you can see a question which is there in your screen. A charge capacitor of capacitance C is discharged through a resistance R. Okay. So whenever you hear such thing, immediately that formula comes in your mind, right? That charge at any point in time should be equal to Q naught e to the power minus T by RC, right? So this is the formula for discharging of the capacitor. All right. Then a radioactive sample decays with an average life tau. So average life is tau. So lambda is equal to what? 1 by tau, right? Because tau is equal to 1 by lambda, all right? Find the value of R for which the ratio of electrostatic field energy stored in the capacitor to the activity of the radioactive sample remains constant in time. Now, energy as a function of time in the capacitor, how will we find out? Energy is Q square by 2C, isn't it? And charge at any point in time is given by equation number one, all right? So I can use equation number one over here and write this down as, this will be Q naught square e to the power minus 2T by RC, okay? This is Q square, that divided by 2C, all right? And ratio of this, the energy to the activity should be constant. Now, activity is what? Activity of a radioactive sample is dN by dt, right? And dN by dt is, if I just talk about magnitude of the activity, is lambda times N, okay? And N as a function of time is given as N naught e to the power minus lambda t. Okay, so this is what we have. And now if I take the ratio should be independent of time. Okay, so if I take ratio of energy with activity, let's say activity, which is dN by dt, if I write it like this, what I'll get is Q naught square by 2C, fine, lambda N naught e to the power minus 2t by RC multiplied by e to the power lambda t, fine. So basically this entire thing, this thing is a constant, right? So let that be a constant K, all right? This is K into e to the power minus of 2 by RC minus lambda times T, okay? Now, if this ratio is independent of time, then what should happen? The ratio is independent of time, then coefficient of this time should be equal to 0, right? So 2 divided by RC minus lambda should be equal to what? 0, okay? We need to find what? We need to find the value of R. Now, the value of R from this, you will get it by solving this equation. So 2 by RC, 2 divided by RC is equal to lambda, fine. So R is equal to what? R is equal to 2 by C times lambda, where C is the capacitance. So this is how you solve this particular question. So I hope you have learned something today. In case you have any doubts, please feel free to get in touch with us. Okay, thank you.